Live NFL trivia every Tuesday night on Twitch at 9 p.m. Eastern. Come show off your football knowledge and have a chance to win cash prizes. Check the link in the description to find out more. And now, on with our feature presentation. You've all seen the play by now. You all know what happens here. Gregg Williams, for some inexplicable reason, decides to call cover zero, leaving Henry Ruggs, arguably the fastest receiver in football besides Tyreek Hill, one-on-one with an undrafted rookie cornerback and no safety help. The result is incredibly predictable. Carr finds Ruggs for the game-winning touchdown, and the Jets somehow pull defeat from the jaws of victory and lose 31-28. Normally, I'd make this an episode of Dumb Decisions, and say that this was the worst Hail Mary defense of all time. Heck, it's right up there with what the Bengals did in 1987 against the 49ers, when they decided to just leave Jerry Rice uncovered on the last play of the game for no particular reason. You can check that video out in the upper right corner. But I can't do that here, simply because this dumb decision might turn out to be one of the greatest things to happen in the 60-year history of the franchise should the Jets wind up with Trevor Lawrence and the number one overall pick. I had to approach this from a different angle, and an angle that I haven't seen anyone take yet. Now, off the top of my head, I could not think of a single instance of a team just playing cover zero in an obvious Hail Mary situation. The old saying is that prevent defense prevents your team from winning, but that's normally from the perspective of loosening up coverage late in the game and allowing the opposition to drive down the field and pick up big chunk plays. That's not necessarily applicable on Hail Mary attempts. On the Hail Mary, you send the bulk of your team back and just tell them to knock it down. You don't ever see single coverage in an all-out blitz like what Gregg Williams did. The tanking explanation for why he did it doesn't apply, because as suspicious as it looked to play that kind of coverage in that situation, Williams got fired the next day. And that might be his last shot ever at being a defensive coordinator, because him going rogue like that is not going to lead too many coaches to welcome him with open arms, especially considering his controversial past. So as fun as it might be to assume that this was a tank job, let's just throw that out of the window. The second explanation is that this is just what Gregg Williams does. Dan Orlovsky put this tweet out shortly after the game with that explanation. As a historian of the game and as a disgruntled Jaguars fan who realized that our chances of getting Trevor Lawrence just slipped away because of Williams, I had to do some digging. So that's exactly what I did. I looked at every single Hail Mary attempt that Gregg Williams had to defend in his entire career, either as a defensive coordinator or head coach of the team. First, we need to define what a Hail Mary situation is. I'm considering a Hail Mary to be any situation near midfield in the fourth quarter where the touchdown will either win the game, tie it, or potentially tie it with a two-point conversion. It's one of those things where you know it when you see it. Then I looked at how Gregg Williams' defense defended the play, and the results from this were somewhat surprising. With that being said, excluding Sunday's game, I counted 15 situations where Gregg Williams' defense had to defend a Hail Mary. For four of these plays, I could not find any footage whatsoever, so we're scrapping them. These four games came in a 1998 game between the Oilers and the Jaguars, a 1999 game between the Titans and the Ravens, a 2000 game between the Titans and Washington, and a 2004 game between Washington and the Lions. For the other 11, I found the footage. Let's start with this 1998 game between the Oilers and the Ravens. Pretty standard Hail Mary defense. Williams rushes three, and it's successful. This is the only camera angle I could find for this 1999 one between the Titans and the Bengals to open up the season. And at least from what I can tell, this is your typical Hail Mary defense. There were five Titans around the ball to prevent Carl Pickens from catching it, so they had ample bodies back there. Again, there were three other instances of a Gregg Williams Hail Mary happening while he was in Tennessee, but I found no footage of them. During his time as the head coach of the Buffalo Bills, there were two instances of his team being in a Hail Mary situation. The first came in a Week 1 game against the New York Jets, where the Jets were looking for a Hail Mary to avoid overtime. Standard Hail Mary defense, with a delayed blitzer at the end. Bills are still rushing just four guys, with everyone else dropping back into coverage. The second came in a Week 15 game against the San Diego Chargers. Again, this is pretty standard, nothing at all like what we saw on Sunday. The Bills are only rushing three guys here. Now let's look at his tenure with Washington as their defensive coordinator. While I could not find footage for the first of these instances, there were two other moments where his defense faced a Hail Mary situation. The first came in the iconic Monday Night Football comeback against the Cowboys in 2005. Once again, they're only rushing three guys. Everyone else drops back into coverage, whether it's shallow or deep. You can see at the onset that there are three safeties back near the end zone, just in case Drew Bledsoe decides he wants to reach the end zone and throw it deep. And later in the season, in a game against the Chargers, once again, Williams decides to only send three. The same thing happens in the first of these situations as the defensive coordinator with the Saints, where he sent three against the Falcons, and later in that 2009 season, when he only sent three against the Rams. So far, I've looked at 8 Hail Mary attempts. On all 8 of them, Williams either sent 3 or 3 with a delayed blitzer on the 4th. He played a standard defense for that type of situation. So how do we get from there to what happened on Sunday? Well, something happened when the Saints played the Bengals in 2010. The Bengals trail 34-30, and with 8 seconds left, it is a Hail Mary situation. And instead of playing the typical Hail Mary defense, Gregg Williams sends 6. He sends pressure onto Carson Palmer and company, and that ends the game. For the first time, he changed what his usual strategy was, and instead of dropping back into coverage, he sent the house. I have a completely unsubstantiated theory about why this happened. This game between the Saints and the Bengals took place in Week 13 of the 2010 season. What happened 3 weeks prior, when the Saints were on bye and Gregg Williams was probably back home watching Sunday's slate of games? As you might have been able to guess, that was the day that the David Garrard Hail Mary to Mike Thomas happened. During that play, the Texans only rushed 3, much like what Gregg Williams was doing his whole career. The Texans played it pretty well. Glover Quinn did what everyone is told to do in that situation, and simply knock it down. Instead, he bats it right into the hands of Mike Thomas. Because the Saints happened to be on bye that week, because Williams was probably watching that game, and because that play happened the way that it did, it would not surprise me if Williams changed his philosophy on that day. And why do I say that? Because in every other Hail Mary situation since then, Williams has brought pressure. He sent 6 against the Panthers in 2011. When he was with the Rams in 2016, he sent 6 against the Cardinals. And obviously Sunday, he sent the house against the Raiders. It's actually bizarre how he never sent pressure for the first decade or so of his coaching career. And then the moment the David Garrard Hail Mary happened, he never dropped everyone back after that. Plus, if it ain't broke, don't fix it, right? He got the sack sending the house against the Bengals. Cam Newton got hit and got nowhere close to reaching the end zone on that 2011 attempt. And Drew Stanton had to get his throw off so quickly that no receiver was even in the end zone by the time the ball got there. So why would Gregg Williams change something that has clearly worked for him? Even on the previous Hail Mary attempts where he was playing prevent defense, even though it worked, the ball still got to the end zone a bit, and some of those plays were a bit antsy, particularly the one against the Chargers in 2005 where there was a deflection. By setting the house, you don't even give the quarterback that chance to reach the end zone. Do I agree with the strategy? Absolutely positively not. I do not agree with it at all. I think you take your chances with strength and numbers, and you especially don't leave the fastest receiver in football in single coverage in a situation like that. But after going through this analysis, I can emphatically say that I agree with Dan Orlovsky. At least in the past decade, as stupid as it might seem, this is just what Gregg Williams does. Be sure to like this video, ring the notification bell, subscribe down below if you haven't already, as it helps the channel out a lot. And be sure to check out Twitch every Tuesday night at 9 p.m. Eastern for your chance to play NFL trivia and win cash prizes. Link in the description below. If you want to see videos like this condensed down to 60 seconds, then follow me on TikTok at JarrowGator9 and subscribe to 60-second NFL history on YouTube. Also, special thanks to all of our Patreon supporters for helping the channel. Your support is greatly appreciated. So you can become a patron and request future video topics in the description below.